Happy Monday, Flextech. Welcome to this week's episode of the Weekly Flex. Last week before spring break. Let's make it a good one. I'm Evie. Roll the intro. Next year? We really hope so. If you have not completed the re-enrollment form for the 2021-22 school year, please do so ASAP. You can find the form on our website or in front of the office. Spring break is just days away. All of you have been working so hard during this very challenging school year. A nice, relaxing break is just what we all need. The Weekly Flex wants to remind you that if you are traveling during break, please be sure to be mindful of the COVID protocols. If for some unfortunate reason you get sick over break, quarantining afterwards may be necessary. Please be safe and have a fun break.
Hey FlexTech, I hope you're having a great day so far. I'm coming to you today with a few updates about COVID. So recently we've learned that Livingston County has crossed back into the high-risk threshold for the spread of COVID. The health department is contributing this, likely, to the spread of the new variant, which is 2 to 3 times more contagious than the previous COVID-19 variant. For the first time, school-aged children, that category, has surpassed any other adult group. This is new because usually school-aged children like yourselves aren't the ones who have a high positivity rate or are very contagious in spreading the disease. But as of late, school-aged children are spreading it just as much as any other age group. So for us, this means we really need to tighten up on our policies and protocols that we've had in place since the beginning of the school year. We need to make sure that we're not eating in class, we're not drinking in class. If you need to have a drink, you can step out in the hall to remove your mask and then put it back on when you come back into the classroom. Same thing with blowing your nose. At lunch, the weather's getting nicer, so we encourage you to eat outdoors whenever possible. The courtyard's open for you to eat, or you can walk around outside. Make sure that you are maintaining social distancing when you remove your mask, especially. So if you're going to eat with friends, that's fine, but take off your mask to eat and then put it back on when you're done eating. Make sure that you are at least 6 feet apart, meaning you cannot touch each other if you hold your arms out. And we strongly discourage students from carpooling. I understand that many do in order to get to and from school, but try to limit your pod, so to speak, to just a couple of students, because we've found that students have come to school in the past without knowing they've had COVID and then spread it to those who are in their carpool group. Lastly, we've sent out an announcement about spring break. Unless you've been fully vaccinated, and it's unfortunately unlikely that you have, you are strongly discouraged from traveling to hotspots like California, Texas, Florida, and New York. If you do go to those places, please do not gather with other people, socially distance, stay with your family group, and avoid crowds. And of course, wear a mask. If you do go to those places, even if you do all those things, you need to communicate that with the school so that we can make arrangements for you to quarantine for 7 days after your return and make sure that you can attend your classes virtually. Please communicate with us if your plan is to go to California, Texas, Florida, and New York so that we can make those arrangements. If there are any questions, please reach out to me or Mrs. Combs so that we can help answer any of those that you have. We hope you have a great day and a great rest of your week, and enjoy spring break. but please do so safely. Thank you.
Now for your weekly testing week reminder. Testing week is Monday, April 12th through Thursday, April 15th. Pre-ID for testing will occur the week we get back from break. It is vital that all students attend for pre-ID, so make sure you're here. So, if you're not going to be in school, please inform your advisor or Ms. Combs. And speaking of Ms. Combs, let's see this tech tip from her.
Hey there, I am coming at you today with another tech tip that might not be very new to you, but could be super helpful for some of you. So at this point in the year, you have learned a lot already. You've had a lot of assignments, you've completed a lot of projects, and if you've missed a few assignments, it might start to feel overwhelming to think about what you have to focus on or prioritize in order to complete your missing work. So the good news is that Google Classroom actually has some tools to help you prioritize what you need to do. So when you log into Google Classroom, you will see your classes here. Hopefully you have a few less than me. And then up at the top, you'll see a couple of buttons that you can click. You probably won't see this to review tab unless you are a teacher for a class, but you should see this to do button and the calendar button. If you click on the to do button, it's going to show you, I don't have anything because I'm not a student in most of my classes that I run, but you will see different tabs up here that you can toggle between that will show you what assignments you have. So if you click on the assigned tab, it's just going to show you all assignments that have been assigned to you. And you can switch from your classes up here at the top. You will see a few more than I'm seeing here. And if you want to prioritize your missing assignments, you would click the missing tab and you might see all of your missing assignments for all of your classes right away. If that's overwhelming for you, you could also click up here and switch to only view one class at a time if you want to prioritize work that way. And if you want to feel really good about yourself and everything you've already accomplished, or look back and see teacher feedback on assignments that you've completed, then you can also click on the Done tab, and that will show you work that you submitted. And I believe it'll also show you what grade you've received on that assignment if it's been returned with a grade already. So I hope this is helpful. I hope this helps you prioritize your work as you are completing up the school year. And let me know if you have any tech tips that you would like to share.
Hello, FlexTech. If you're looking for a gaming community and you're a gamer like me, try joining our FlexTech Game Club, which will be starting up on March 22nd, and we'll start introductions at 4:30, and then that Thursday, the 25th, we'll have an open gaming session starting at 6 p.m. Hope to see you there.
As you've seen in the most recent episodes, March is Women's History Month. For our last episode of the month, the Weekly Flex wants to celebrate Katherine Johnson, Dorothy Vann, and Mary Jackson. These three African-American women mathematicians worked as computers for NASA during the space race to the moon. An award-winning film was made in 2016 detailing their story, which has reminded us all of the important role women have played at every turning point in history.
Equilateral, isosceles, tetrahedron.
I have never seen a mind like the one your daughter has. You have to see what she becomes.
Come on! Uh-huh. Like that.
Catherine, we all gonna end up unemployed riding around in this pile of junk.
You're welcome to walk the 16 miles.
Or sit in the back of the bus.
Kiss me up.
You have identification on?
We're just on our way to work at NASA, sir.
I had no idea they hired.
There are quite a few women working in the space program.
You know what we're doing here? We're putting a human on top of a missile, shooting them into space that's never been done before.
I need a mathematician that can look beyond the numbers. Math that doesn't yet exist.
You have someone? Running what I'm
playing. Catherine's the gal for that. She can handle any numbers you put in front of her.
You're a computer at NASA. They let women handle that sort of...
Yes, they let women do some things at NASA, Mr. Johnson.
And it's not because we wear skirts. It's because we wear glasses.
You've been gone for 300 hours.
Was Mama gone for 12 and a half days?
No, but it felt like it.
In 14 days, astronauts will be here for training. Everything we do can matter to their wives, to their children. I believe it's going to matter to the whole country.
My gals are ready.
There's no protocol for women attending.
There's no protocol for a man circling the Earth either, sir.
We all get there together, we don't get there at all.
Let me ask you, if you were a white male, would you wish to be an engineer?
I wouldn't have to. I'd already be one.
Don't you know that we're able?
Hello!
Hey there!
It's a portrait of a graduate problem solver. These activities are here that we're going to talk about here are what you're going to be doing over these next couple weeks. And these will be connected to points and stuff. I'm going to let Miss Austad to start with explaining the one that you can be doing as a cool advisory, a building challenge.
So we got some really fun stuff planned for you. So this is our cool challenge box. Now inside your box, you're going to find some very challenging hands-on puzzles. You're also gonna have a building challenge. So we'll provide you the materials and the instructions are very specific. It's not just a build, there's gonna be a structure that you're gonna log into Zoom and you're gonna see the structure. And then there's the spy who can see the structure. Then you have the informant who will come and get directions from the spy, and then you'll have the builder. So there's a little twist to this challenge. So not everyone can see the structure. Only one person can see it, only one person can talk. Builders can't even talk to each other while they're building. So make sure you follow the instructions for this fun build.
Sounds like a problem.
It is a problem.
So you have to solve it because it's problem solving. next thing, So next thing is that in this box there are puzzles for you to do, and some of you have tried them in your classes, but we made them on the laser cutter. If you don't know, we have those.
Q made them on the laser cutter.
Yeah. So there are these puzzles for you to play. So all of these pieces can fit in these puzzles, and you just have to figure out which is which. They're leveling varying levels of difficulty, and depending on the ones that you solve, you'll get a certain amount of points for your advisory. There's also a Rubik's Cube in here, and what you need to do is that your advisor will need to prove that you're able to solve these, and they'll just take a picture and submit that to us, and that can score you points for your advisory.
Woohoo! Points, points, points! It's all competition.
More problems.
More problems, more points. Now we also have video riddles for you. So we put the Nearpod code right on the box. So the idea is that if you have 10 people in your advisory, you can divide this box up. We could have 3 or 4 people building, 3 or 4 people doing hands-on puzzles, and then individual students could do riddles or in groups or pairs, depending on what the teacher wants to do. So you get on that Nearpod and you'll have video riddles and a couple other little picture riddles for you.
More puzzles, more problems.
Q, where are we keeping all this information on if they're solving?
Okay, so your advisor will get this from my room. We only have 6 boxes. There's obviously more than 6 advisories happening at the same time. So advisors, you will just have to figure out when you will do it for your advisor. We'll also be talking about that at another time. But that's what you have to know for the announcements.
And advisors, what you're gonna do is track this on a Google form. So we'll have a Google form for you so you can be able to track who's solving what and we'll divvy up the points.
And that will all lead to more money, more problems now.
True.
No.
It's a true statement.
But that'll all lead to, I'm saying it, guess.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That was my drum roll.
For me,
yeah.
Apparently, to a big, on the end of the market period, for instead of having an assembly with a guest speaker, we'll have a challenge for all the schools.
Yes, big problem-solving challenges with a grand prize, okay? More to come.
Yeah.
Thank you. See ya, problem solvers.
The Weekly Flex and the Media Arts team are excited to announce the 6th FlexTap Film Festival. The Media Arts students are working hard to plan and promote the event, along with producing original content. All FlexTap students are invited to submit work to be played at the festival. Feature films, documentaries, music videos, PSAs, social media content, and more. The 2021 FlexTap Film Festival will take place on May 26th. Deadline for submissions is May 21st. Stay tuned in the coming weeks for more details. And finally, if you haven't noticed the large shout-out banner hanging outside of room 105, where have you been? FlexTech wants students to feel empowered to praise and recognize their peers for all of the reasons they deserve it. We want to build a community that is positive, supportive, and belonging. Check these out.
Shout out to Jake for turning 18.
I want to shout out all my senior advisees. They're doing amazing. They're crushing it. But I want to, this week, I want to shout out to Jake Somm. It's his birthday. Happy birthday. And he is crushing math, thanks to Ms. Hemmer and Ms. Finn, which I want to shout out to them too. But he actually likes math. He can do it. He's doing it. Very exciting.
Hey, I'd like to give a shout out to the homeboy, Jake and Jacob, because they're homeboys.
Aloha, Mrs. Austad here, and I want to shout out to Jake Somm. Yes, it is his 18th birthday, which is amazing because he is now officially an adult. But the real reason I'm shouting him out is because he conquered math. He did not let math defeat him. He defeated math, and he is going to go on to his adulthood just knowing how to conquer numbers. So this is for you, Jake. Happy birthday.
Thanks, Ms. Austad.
I would like to shout out Ms. Falling because she really helps me out with everything that I do in school, and she's always super nice to me and makes sure I'm comfortable and that I'm passing.
I would like to shout out Mrs. Combs because I just wanted to take a moment to share how grateful I am for her because she is just always there for me and always listens to me and helps me with whatever I need, and I'm just so, so grateful for her.
That's it for this episode of the Weekly Flex. Thanks so much for spending your time with us on this Monday. I'm Evie. Please have a great week and a safe, fun spring break.